Kalkadosh Erev Tov, this is Mishnah Yomi, Perek Zayin of Masechet Baba Kama. We are going to do right now Mishnah Hey Vav and also Zayin to catch up. So we're going to do 5, 6, and 7, and with this we're going to finish chapter 7. Mishnah Hey comes and it says as follows. We're going to be listing other cases where again the thief is going to be exempt from Arba V'Chamisha, from the 4 and 5 payments. Mecharo chutz me'echad mi'mea shebo. What happens if he sold the animal, but he kept for himself 1/100? So he sold 99% of the animal, but he kept one. He had a partnership in the animal, right? Or he slaughtered it, but it came in nevila in the shechita, means the shechita was not done properly. Or he slit the pipes, right, lengthwise, or he tore them out, which again was not a proper shechita. So in all these cases, he's going to pay kefel, but not arba'a v'chamisha. Okay? Now he says, ganav birshuta bealim. What happens now if he steals it in the property of the bealim? Now he slaughters it and sells it outside of their property. Or he stole it outside of their property, but he slaughtered it in their property. Or he stole the animal and slaughtered it, sold it outside of the property of the owner. So in all these cases, he's going to pay arba'a v'chamisha. Since in all these cases, he must have pulled the animal at least a little distance, and therefore he did a meshicha. Remember, he made an act of acquisition, which means he made a kinyan. So in such a case, he's obligated as a thief. And therefore the thief is going to be including the 4 and 5 times. Aval ganav v'tavach u'machah b'shutam. But if he did everything in the owner's property, so therefore, since there was never a kinyan done, he's going to be patur from paying the why? Because if he didn't actually make an act of acquisition, so he's not going to be obligated to pay the arba'a v'chamisha. Mishnah Vav, Mishnah number 6. We just learned the concept of meshicha, which is basically you have to pull it towards you, and therefore now you're going to be chayav because you stole it. But if you didn't do any kinyan, so you're not going to pay anything. What about kefel? Imagine right now, you're trying to pull the animal out, and it died. But it's still in the reshut of the owners. Meaning you never got it out of the property of the owners. You're going to be exempt from all payments. But if you picked it up, or you took it outside of the property of the owners, and now it dies, you're going to be chayav. Why? Because now you already went, and you acquired it, so therefore you're going to be chayav on the kefen. If right now you came and you gave it to the redemption of Pidyon Bechor, Pidyon Ben, you want to do Pidyon Ben, or Lebal Chovo, you want to pay somebody back that you owe him, or Shomer Chinam, or Leshoel, you give it to an unpaid watchman, or to a borrower, or Nusesachar to a paid watchman, or to a socher, to a renter, and he's pulling it out, and it dies in the property in the domain of the owner, Patur, he's going to be exempt. Because again, nobody made any type of a kinyan. Higbiyo, but if he did pick it up, or he took it outside of the Rishut Rabbeinim of Emet and it died, he's going to be chayav. The last Mishnah in Perek Zayin, you're not allowed to raise, right, small domestic animals in Eretz Yisrael. We're talking about the sheep and goats because they could damage the crops. But you could do it in Syria, right? In Syria, which is not part of Eretz Yisrael. Okay, or in the wilderness of Eretz Yisrael, where there's no crops, you're allowed to do that. You're never allowed to raise chickens in Yerushalayim. Why? Because then the chickens, they might cause a lot of tum'ah, because they could come, you know, pecking around and doing all the things. Or even Kohanim cannot raise chickens anywhere, right? Because of tarot also. Because if they have the tarot, it could be make tameh, tum'ah, so therefore it's going to become very, very problematic. Okay, so he comes and he says here, that this is now coming with the following now. Okay, he comes and he says, you're not allowed to raise pigs in any place. Okay, this was a decree, what happened, right? If you see that when it went into the wall, right, they put it, the nails into the wall, its hooves, and then they made a curse, right? The Gemara is going to explain about it, that they didn't want any types of pigs in Eretz Yisrael. You're not allowed to raise a dog unless it's going to be tied with a chain, because again, obviously an untied dog might frighten a pregnant woman and cause her to miscarriage, and therefore he's not allowed to. Right, you're also not allowed to put traps for the doves unless the trap is going to be at least 30 ris away from a nested area, because if not, then you're going to come and try to trap the birds from other places, and then it's going to become a problem of stealing. Have a wonderful day.